Hi, I'm Carl with D-Glass 3D, and I'm here today to talk to you about the Rugged HPX2 Max Extruder, which is a dual extruder that fits in the same footprint and is about the same weight as a traditional single extruder. And the way that we accomplish this is with our gear transmission. The transmission has first and second gear, where the first gear is dedicated to filament number one, and then the second gear is dedicated to the other. The other key aspect is the filament shifter technology, which essentially allows that transmission to shift from first to second when the software calls for a material change. The other key aspect is that the shifter allows for infinitely adjustable retraction, and the retraction is set in the slicing program just as it would with any traditional single or dual extruder. The other question that we get oftentimes is, how is the HPX2 mounted and adapted to our printer? The first answer to that is really in the universal mount that we've got designed here that I'm showing on the bottom of our mocked-up HPX2 Max. We've got two slots, one set on either side of the universal mount, and these slots are cut at diagonal angles. And the design intent there is to really provide maximum flexibility for your 3D printer. The other key aspect, and this is true for any dual extruder, is that you need to have expandability in your control board to extruders. And that comes into play with the heaters and the thermistors. And if you have that, then that's a good first step. The next step is the servo control. It's necessary to have a servo signal that drives the servo, allowing for the shifter to take place. Now, we've found from our research and testing that most, if not all, of the boards that are on the market today that have the expandability for two hot ends also have a connection available for a servo. We continue to do testing on this, and you can see at the bottom of this video, we have a table that's a compatibility table. And it essentially outlines the level of difficulty in adapting the HPX2 Max to many of the common printers that are out there on the market. We've broken it down into a couple of different categories. First being mechanical, primarily focusing on the mounting situation. And then the second is electrical. How easy is it to plug and play the HPX2 Max into your printer? We're going to have a series of additional videos and technical updates out in the coming weeks, and this is just the first that addresses compatibility. So thanks so much for watching, and thank you for your support on our Kickstarter campaign.